Dr. Aaron Uthoff here from Auckland University of Technology and the Sport Performance Research Institute of New Zealand. I'm here today to share with you some insights how you can use EXOGEN Wearable Resistance cast sleeves to take your sprint game to the next level. I've been researching how to get athletes faster and applying these learnings to my practice for nearly a decade now. Along that journey, I've worked with athletes all the way from youth, grassroots level, to Olympic medalists at the top of their game. And what I've learned along this journey is that my real passion lies in this area of bridging the gap between research and practice. So that's taking what happens with these researchers and scientists do in a lab setting, and what these coaches do in their practical application working with athletes on a day-to-day basis, and melding it together, and then teaching people how to apply these scientific principles of sports and exercise science to optimize their athlete's performance. One aspect that's been really interesting to me is this idea of transference. So is what you're doing in the gym or what you're doing on the field, these exercises that you're always working on, that people tell you are to get you better, faster, stronger, are they actually transferring to making you faster on the track, the court, or the field? Well, several years ago, as I was invited to be a part of this research team looking at the effects of this novel resistance training tool, wearable resistance, on the effects of sprinting technique and force application. Now, from that research, it just opened my mind to this world of how we can apply the idea of specificity to your training. And I haven't stopped researching it since. Now, when you think about it, speed in its most simple form is just stride length or step length, how far you step on each stride, and stride frequency. So how fast you can turn your legs over in order to beat your opposition to the ball or in order to win that scoring try, whatever it might be, okay? Now, what we found is when we load 200, 400, 600 grams, these here, 200 grams, that's 8 ounces for any of those North American folks, that's half a pound, 600 grams onto the calf, what we find is that this overloads the stride frequency component of that model. Now, this is done primarily because they have about a 2% longer ground contact time and about a 3% longer flight time. Now, what I'm talking about with ground contact time is the time that your foot hits, strikes the ground, you're in single support, and that flight time is the time when both feet are off the ground before you hit your next step. Okay? What was really interesting from all this research is that athletes can get faster using it. It can overload the stride frequency component, but what doesn't happen is you don't see differences in ground reaction forces, either vertical or horizontal. So this leads us to understand that when you load the calf during sprinting, where the primary overload occurs is in rotation, right? So it happens here, not just straight down in the ground, not just straight back behind you. So that's just one of the fantastic things about wearable resistance, especially the calf sleeve that we can use, okay? Along with this, what we're also seeing is if you're getting greater rotational inertia, so you're getting greater overload of the joints, when you load the calf, what happens is you load across the muscles across the knee and across the hip, okay? So theoretically, what you can do is just say that this is gonna train those muscles, and there's likely gonna be adaptations to improve performance. And primarily in the realm of neurological adaptation. So your firing frequency is probably gonna be a bit higher. Your synchronization will likely increase. So therefore being able to enhance your sprint capabilities. When it comes to integrating calf sleeves into your training, there's three things that you need to consider. One, how to wear the sleeve. Two, some of the loading terminology and placements for it. And then three, how are you going to progressively overload this over about 6 weeks and integrate it into your training cycle? So one, how do you wear it? Okay. The calf sleeves are pretty simple. They've got a top and a bottom. All right. And what you do is, it's pretty simple. You just look at the tag here. It's going to tell you what your size is. It's going to tell you whether it's a right or a left. And then you just slap that bad boy on. Okay, simple as that. Strap that baby down and boom, there you go. Now, what you're looking for here is you're looking to ensure that this gap is on the outside, kind of towards that malleolus. You want to make sure that these straps are nice and tight around the top to hold it in place above that cap. The bottom strap is just kind of there to hang on. Okay. Now, when we're talking about loading terminology, there's three ideas that you need to think about. And if you've ever taken anatomy or physiology class, you might be familiar with these terms, all right? So the first one is anterior, posterior, all right? So anterior, posterior refers to either the front or the back of the body. So are you either gonna load the anterior aspect of it, or are you gonna load the posterior aspect, okay? Next you gotta think about is whether you're gonna go medial or lateral, okay? When you think of medial, you're just thinking, okay, towards the center of body, all right? Am I gonna take this, I'm gonna take the fat end, the belly portion of this, put it right to the inside. That is a medial loading strategy, okay? The next one is gonna be lateral. So you just take that fat end, lateral just means away from the center line of the body, in there. Finally, what you gotta think about is whether you're gonna go proximal or distal, okay? Proximal just means that it is closer to the center of mass, okay? So if I'm here, it's gonna be closer to my knee, right? So if I load fat end up, the belly up, that is proximally loaded. Or I can load here to have it proximal. Now as I progress, I can progress that distally, all right? So move it further towards the ankle. What that's gonna do is that's gonna increase rotational inertia, so it's gonna provide more overload. So it's really important to think that with this loading placement comes your progression, and you gotta be smart and safe with how you're doing it. How are you gonna progressively overload this safely? How are you gonna integrate this into your training program? All right, well, it's pretty easy, three-step process, okay? Weeks 1 and 2, you're just gonna take 200 grams, put it proximally, belly up, and there you go. You go do your sprint training, you go take care of your business, you go make sure that you get a little bit faster, all right? Now, weeks 3 and 4, what we're looking to do is you're just gonna add another 200 grams to that, all right? So now we're up to 400. Okay, same thing. You don't need to switch up what you're doing in your program. You just keep doing your day-to-day business. You keep doing your drills, you keep doing your sprints, you keep getting faster. This is just gonna overload that component. Now, to finish off these final week 5 and 6, what you're gonna do is you're gonna move the final 200 grams anterior, okay? Again, belly side up. Now, you've got 600 grams on your calf. That's enough, okay? This is a simple, safe, and effective progression that you can use to ensure that you're getting you and your athletes faster.